And they use this thing called Facebook. I don't really understand it. Yeah,
that's a
young person's thing. Facebook.
Sasha and Malia, are they on Facebook?
No.
No?
I'm not a big fan of young kids having Facebook. It's not something they need. It's not necessary.
U.S. President Barack Obama has banned his adolescent daughters from using Facebook. The president does not want his private family life details to be made public. Why would we want to have a whole bunch of people who we do not know knowing our business? He used Twitter and Facebook extensively, in fact, during his 2008 campaign. Obama is using social media exhaustively, even for his re-election bid.
Is there any advice you can give me, things I need to know?
Well, I want everybody here to be careful about what you post on Facebook. Whatever you do, it will be pulled up again later somewhere in your life. And when you're young, you know, you make mistakes and you do some stupid stuff. And I've been hearing a lot about young people who, you know, they're posting stuff on Facebook and then suddenly they go apply for a job and somebody's done a search and, you know, so that's some practical political advice for you right there.
Facebook could be a useful tool if we would change a few of our behaviors. We should humble ourselves, stop showing off, stop envying others, stop having so much pride. Do you see a friend having trouble? Offer to help by sharing, by giving support, and by encouraging them. Promote peace by making friends with people from other nations and other cultures. Spread truth, not lies. Think before you pass a rumor on to your friends, are you sure that rumor is true? Stop hating others, but instead, love everyone. If you use Facebook, please use it wisely, or don't use it at all. Obama used social media to gain the most powerful public office in the world. Social media is powerful. We could use social media to spread peace. Why don't we? These lessons are from a book much older than Facebook, the Holy Bible. Credit for teaching goes to Jesus Christ, who said, "A new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another, as I have loved you, that ye also love one another."